Chris. A-Hole Productions. I hear you, Deadeye. It's not always, it's not, yeah, we don't have to get into a philosophical, I'm not trying to have a philosophical conversation. Rare achievement unlocked, into the depths, escape from the ship. It can't be that rare. I mean, I'm sure everyone does that. Like, I'm sure everyone who plays this game eventually will get that achievement. It can't be that rare. All right, shit. I think we're up to our waist in bullshit right now. Yeah, we are. Fuck. Hey, back from school, are you? Hey, what's up, Lady Love? Lady Love, you back from school? Damn, look at this place. Is that? Oh, nothing. Damn. Whoa. What the fuck is this place? Holy shit. Ooh, let's swim around out here. Look, oh, the fish are dead. Shit, bro. Oh, the fish are dead. Oh, what's all this? Flame rounds, hey. I'll fucking take it. Shit on me. I was hoping we'd find something. That's better than I thought. I was kind of hoping for a coin, to be honest, but I'll take some fucking flame rounds. Moobot, thank you, Moobot. Alright, looks like we're going under. So we still haven't dealt with Lucas yet, and we still haven't dealt with the grandma. I'm assuming the grandma has something to do with this. Because the picture said Evelyn 001, and it showed the grandma's face. So, or showed a picture of the grandma. So, how did the two connect? That's what we got to figure out next. Oh, look at that. February 18th, 1892, there was a collapse in the Patterson mine. Tern and Beckford are dead, and Huxley will never walk on his own again. Old man Stan was right. The ground there is too unstable. The company's, 1892, February 19th, the company's not going to send us any replacements. They want us to work double shifts instead. I can't wait to get back to the old country. Whoa. Some history here. Abercrombie Salt Mine, South Dalby. I am still in school, but I am in pride right now. The teacher doesn't care if we are on the computer. Oh, that's awesome. That's pretty cool. Flame rounds and water, huh? Yeah. I'm wondering if I'm going to, if they're, like, it's a blank or something. Hey, it's the umbrella photo. Are they watching us from the helicopter? It's the umbrella photo from the, oh, it looks different here, though. I don't know if the photo's more faded or it just has a different logo on it, or you can't see it. Or maybe it's not umbrella, but that's in the demo. It's an umbrella logo. Who's this?
Alpha One, this is Bravo One. Do you read?
Alpha.
Did you find anything? A thorough search of the Baker property revealed zero survivors. Repeat, zero survivors. We did find evidence of a skirmish.
Whoa.
Evelyn. Negative. However, we did find several encrypted messages from the Baker's son, Lucas, to an unknown third party. You can probably guess who that was.
That's just great. We've had reports he's in the abandoned mine south of the property. I'm gonna go have a look.
Roger that. We'll meet you at those coordinates.
If you encounter Evelyn, orders are shoot to kill. Repeat, shoot to kill.
So the whatever company that Mia worked for is looking for them. Just took them a while to find him, I guess. Holy shit. Ship, swamp, lab? What? Oh, the birdcage. Someone moved the birdcages here. Well, we don't have any of our shit on us right now, video game. Oh, machine gun. Nice. Oh, does Ethan get the machine gun now? That'd be nice. Let's check the inventory. You've taken Mia's things. Fuck yeah. Sorry. Evelyn tissue sample. We're going to hold on to that. That we'll put in the... All right, let's check. Machine gun ammo, check. Enhanced handgun ammo, check. Machine gun, check. We got the survival net. Remote bombs, yes, please. Handgun. That's the standard one that she had, right? But I like the one we fixed up. Machine gun ammo, let's bring all of that. Burner fuel, we're gonna bring that. Look at all this fucking ammo. This is so good. I'm sure we're gonna fucking need it. Shotgun shells, yes. We'll bring the an old-fashioned shotgun. Doesn't hold much, but power, it's quite a punch. We'll just take that one. We'll keep the... Did she have any... We'll keep the grenade launcher and the mag in here for now. Shotgun shells. No, we'll keep those in the thing. We got 30 or so. I think we're good on shotgun shells. First aids, yes. All three of them. Strong first aids, all three of them. Damn. I'm fucking loaded, son. All right. Well, you know, we do need a knife, though. In case we run into any boxes. Well, we don't even need handgun ammo. Did we even bring a handgun with us? There's no handgun here. Let's save the explosives in. Let's bring the survival knife. And I want our handgun. There we go. All right. Shit, dude. Off to work. No problem, Deadeye. Have a good one, dude. Thanks for popping back in, man. All right, new save. Holy shit, guys. Holy shit. How many coins did we have in here? I should have checked that. Ancient coins. We have 3. Let's move them over. And let's put them in this. It's all right. So we need 2 more. So that's pretty simple. Only 3 bird cages. And we've already gotten 2 of them, 2 of the items. I'm going to have to go in like 9 minutes. No problem, Ladybug. Thanks for popping back in, though. Glad your teacher's in a chill mood today. Let's go throw this chem in our box real quick. We don't need it, and I'm trying to keep inventory a little bit tighter than I am right now. Look, I mean, we got a fuck ton of ammo. Holy shit, man. And we've been killing everything in the game. Yeah, this gives me a little bit more hope for Madhouse mode later on, but for now, we're just gonna... Cool. We got 3 inventory slots. That's all I require. Damn, are we going to a fucking lab, dude? And we are. Oh no, we're going to a mine. That's right. It's a mine. It's not a lab. Well, I mean, it says there's a lab, but damn it. God damn it. Anything else you want to fucking give me, game? Like, God damn it, game. I mean, I love you, game. I love you. Just having that shit is nice, but... Alright, let's get back into it. put coin into a birdcage. Yeah, that's where the, so there's three level ups in there. There's a steroid that makes your, adds to your max health, which we've gotten. And then we've also found two out in the middle of the game. Oh shit. Fuck. Well, this isn't really hurting them that much. Damn, we got our ass kicked there. I should have just switched to the shoddy. Yeah, I should say, yeah, or the machine gun, yeah. Oh, I panicked and I grabbed the wrong weapon. I thought I had the explosives. I thought I had the explosives there in that inventory slot. Oh, come on. Shit. Is it just going to keep respawning two guys? Oh, except there's three of them. Why am I not moving? Shit. Shit. These things. Hoboken, no joke, and burn them all. I don't know if we can. Shit. Fuck, this place is creepy. An old mining place, huh? Handgun ammo. Hey, cool. One of these. Oh, an herb. Thank you. Boom. That's all I needed. We have like 400 bullets for this fucking thing. Well, now we got 500 bullets for this thing. Oh my god. Either this game, either we need all of this ammo. Why does Mozart hate chickens? Because they always say Bach. Dude, eat feet, dude. You fucking know how to cheer a brother up, man. Look at this creepy motherfucking place. An old mining facility, huh? That's crazy. Fuck me, this is not what I was expecting it to look like. I mean, I was expecting a mine, obviously, but like a tunnel, but shit. All right, you gotta go. Have a good one, lady. Thank you for popping back in. And congrats again, winning our giveaway earlier. Like I said, I'll be in touch, and we'll figure out when to send that to you. See ya, have fun in school, Deadeye says. Nice. Yeah, thank you all for being just really chill and awesome tonight for this. I really, really appreciate that. It's been nice. As you can tell, I'm super fucking tired. Ouch. I guess I could have kept those mines there and lured them into it. Damn, these things are not fucking quitting. Shit. Damn, dude. Now she's just like, she's just throwing everything she has at us. Well, so I guess we're definitely not going back to the baker. Oh, shit. Did you fucking see how close we got to that? Holy shit. Oh, fuck. That would have been it. That would have been the end of us. See, have you ever been stuck in a dream? Nope. I don't have dreams, like not visual dreams. A lot of my visual memory got fucked up, and there was a time where I thought it was all coming back, and I don't know if it really was or wasn't. Ever since my aneurysm, like, nah, my brain's a fucking pile of mess. So sometimes I think I have dreams, and who knows, maybe I really am. I can't hold on to them long enough. I usually sleep, it's black, and then I wake up, and it's life. That's pretty much the way it is for me. Oh, fuck me, running. So many options. All right, so two ways are a dead end. So that way looks like a dead end. So let's go check out what's over here. Let's just heal right. I'm tired of seeing that blood on the screen. So no, man, you have to tell me what that's like. What's being stuck in a dream like? Oh shit, I don't have enough space. Fucking game. All my weapons are loaded. Shit. And I got two remote bombs anyway. Fuck. Because I really want that mag ammo now. I mean, I guess I can drop something, but... What the fuck am I going to drop? We'll come back for it. Maybe if we use enough... There we go. I was like, maybe if we use enough machine gun rounds, we'll get it. All right. You know what we need to do? For reals, though? It was one bullet? Maybe it wasn't worth it doing for one bullet. A tricky tripwire trap, though. So fucking... I know, dude. That was so fucking close. We were so fucking close to dead on that one. Amen to that, Tony. Yeah, thank goodness my spidey sense went off. Shit. That was pretty sweet. That was pretty sweet. As soon as I saw that cart, I was like, ooh, I bet you we can push this down towards them. But the fact that we got them both in that push was nice. Holy shit, that was cool. All right, so we got left and straight. Nothing this way? Nothing this way. Anything hanging out that we can pick up? Like a coin, maybe? Maybe. Nope. Alright. Looks like we're heading on. The fucking salt mine, dude. Where's TB, man? We need to spread some salt in this motherfucker. Scorched earth? No. Salted earth. Ah, there you go. Eat feet. Nice, dude. Alright, so we were able to pick up two out of the three bullets. Apparently we're full on shotgun shells. I got a shotgun. Man, sorry. I just keep looking for my dog and he's like out, man. Anything behind these rocks? Anybody want to give me a coin? Howdy ho! Oh, fuck! As soon as I fucking ran past it, I saw it. God damn it. God damn it. Fuck, we got booby-trapped once again! Alright, fuck. Alright, we gotta be smart now. Let's use one of the big herbs. Damn it. Damn it. All right. Damn, man, Evelyn fucking rocked this place. Sent Friday, January 16th, 2015. Thanks to you guys, it's been about a week since my head's been clear and back to normal, and she still thinks she's got me. You guys really need to work on fixing that. Not only does she look like a little kid, but she's about as stupid as one. What? Mom and Dad are still totally under, though. I was wondering, is this whole family obsession something you guys programmed into her? It's kind of fucked up. Sent Friday, November 4th, 2015, 2:10 a.m. That bitch Mia is still somewhere in between Evie La La Land and reality. She gets pretty violent, so I locked her up in a cell. Thought maybe Evelyn would get mad since Mia's her favorite and all, but she doesn't seem to care. She actually goes and visits her sometimes. She thinks Mia's her mommy. Like I said, your bioweapon is fucked up. Evelyn's family obsession is getting out of hand. She's making everyone kidnap more and more assholes off the street to add to her freak show of a family. Maybe she's getting tired of Mia not coming around, but it's a pain in the ass for me because I gotta clean up the mess whenever someone new comes along. By the way, Evie's looking sick or something. Her skin is getting all wrinkly and she's getting gray hairs. Is that supposed to happen? It's almost like she's getting old all of a sudden. Booby trap, how did you catch a bra? I'm just going to ask that you will... that will those trap instant kill you and then you just show me? No, I'm not gonna die. I'm trying to keep my death count down for a zombie month. But another time, maybe another playthrough, I will for you, Tony. Bioweapons. Yeah, dude, what the fuck? So someone made Evelyn. You can program stuff into her. And he said she's starting to look old. So I guess the old lady is Evelyn? She's not a little girl? Is she maybe doing like a psychic projection? Oh, shit. Whoa. This is a legit lab. It's like a salt mine, though, right? Like, there shouldn't be like a science lab down here. What's this say? Infection report. The report details the symptoms that appear when the bacterium that grows inside of the E-series infects a human. Be sure to read this document thoroughly before dealing with E-series weaponized assets. Hereafter referred to as mold. Initial infection. The mold ingests nutrients from the subject's body to propagate itself and slowly takes over cells within the body. As a side effect of this, the infected subject gains remarkable regenerative abilities. During experiments, we removed arms and legs from test subjects and found they all were able to coapt the amputated limbs in a matter of minutes. Whoa. What's up, Laz? Thanks for the auto host. Santa, you playing with my smarticules? mid-stage infection. Once the mold reaches the brain, the subject's thoughts become in tune with those of the E-Series asset. The subject starts to hear things and experience hallucinations and soon becomes under complete control of the E-Series asset. If this state continues, the host will lose all sense of ego. Complete infection. After every cell in the body has been taken over by the mold, the subject begins to lose their human form. Physical mutations differ from case to case, but all results in him or her acquiring incredible physical strength. Containing a subject at this stage would be extremely difficult. So I was just thinking too about these sets fire. Welcome back, Seeking Crew. What's up, Santa? Hello, OK Cunning. Thanks for the auto host. I was thinking earlier, you know, when I was walking Echo, I was like, when we were in that like dead world or whatever we were, where we were like, we were seeing like the molded was starting to trying to infiltrate us, and we were seeing Jack Baker and Zoe like as normal people before the infection. We didn't see Marguerite or Lucas. I know Lucas got away, but we didn't see Marguerite there. And I'm wondering if that means Marguerite, if we haven't fully killed her yet. I was just thinking about that. I was like, ooh, I wonder. That'd be pretty interesting. And can we even kill them now, knowing that they're victims? You know, like, how can we do that? That much I learned from E-Necrotoxin E-Series dosage test. 5 minutes after dose, vomiting. Oh, shit. I want to see this real quick. I just wanted to see if there's anything on the back. 5 minutes after. 12 minutes after dose, cell calcification. 10 minutes after dose, death. Okay, so bam, 5 minutes vomiting, 10 minutes death, and then your whole body calcifies. That's intense. Whoa, Zoe gave us that watch. She said it was very important. E-Necrotoxin destroys cells of any subject based on the E-Series bioweapon model, used only for disposal of E-Series assets. The toxin must first be stimulated before use. Do this by placing a sample of the E-Series cells into the necrotoxin container. Okay. Oh. Evelyn's tissue. Luckily we had that on us. Shit. Damn! Just like that, huh? We have a weapon. Ayo! Santa, ayo, 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 ayo! Alright. Well, shit. Evelyn's functions also include the ability to form organisms from mycelia, the fungal filaments. The term organism is used loosely here. What's up, Kitty? And Santa and Deadeye, everyone, thank you for being here. the term organism is used loosely here. Strictly speaking, they are superorganisms formed by countless mycelia. What's important, though, is that they exhibit a strong survival instinct and will defend themselves ferociously with the slightest provocation. Their fungal toughness and remarkable strength give them significant battlefield potential. The researchers have been calling these superorganisms the molded, made of mold and also molded as in shaped. The name has a certain elegance to it. Glad to be here, friend. No problem, Eatfeet. Good to see you, bud. Yeah, I think the girl is the old lady. Because in that last file we read, they said that she's starting to show gray hair and she's starting to age rapidly. So I'm thinking the girl actually is an old lady and just appears in your mind as a girl. Hence the hallucination part. For the treatment of accidental infections, performing blah, blah, blah on samples of Evelyn's body tissue produces a unique fungicidal serum. Administering the serum to an infected subject will cause the mycelia to calcify, but if the subject's cells are already largely invaded, the serum will be fatal. Since the treatment window is so small, the serum's primary use is therefore disposal of infected subjects rather than a cure. In exploring the serum's potential, we found that subjecting it to blank would enhance its effects to extreme potency, becoming a compound we now call E-necrotoxin, which blank in even tiny amounts. So there you go. I guess Zeke just found the plot summary. Pretty much all in one file, or two files. Hey, all, what's up? How you doing, Jomaly? Still at work. But hi. What's been interesting to observe in Evelyn's behavior is her obsession with the concept of family. In experiments, we found on multiple occasions that infected subjects were compelled to act as her mother or father, treating her as if she were really their daughter. Why did she settle upon family as the theme for her mental control? This is just speculation, but it could be that she instinctively understands that a family unit is a better suited to blending into social groups than a lone girl. On the other hand, well, a sentimental sort might suggest that she's making up for a perceived lack of love in her quarantined upbringing, a parent's love. Interesting. So they don't even know why she's evolving in the way that she has. That's pretty neat. Shit. Oh my God, 7 pages of this? What's up, everyone? How's it going? This project was instigated in 2000 as one of the several concepts of the company's NexBuzz, Next Generation Experimental Battlefield Superiority Initiative, working with technical assistance from HCF. HCF! Holy shit! That's a Wesker's company. I was telling you guys about that. Code Veronica, the zombies. We were talking about that in previous streams. The zombies that wear the night goggles in Code Veronica, they were a part of a group called HCF that Wesker was working for. It was who Wesker betrayed Umbrella for when he, in Resident Evil 1, when he was getting the combat data, he was selling it to this organization, HCF. Holy shit! Holy shit! From HCF to develop a bioweapon of neutralizing combatants en masse with minimal direct contact, NexBuzz was later folded and its all assets diverted to this project. What makes this project remarkably different from conventional weapons is its ability to turn enemy combatants into allies, converting hostile elements into willing servants. Oh shit. You're going back to sleep? No problem, kitty. Oh gosh, guys, today is 11 months, is Christmas again. Of course you would say that, Santa. Snap, shit just got real. I know, man. Since this effectively eliminates the cost of not only POW handling, but also combat itself, it's no wonder we had the blank and even blanks, the organization chomping at the bit to get on board. I wish this shit wasn't blanked out. The project would never have existed were it not for the discovery in blank of blank, the remarkably progressed vicariant evolution fungus that we commonly term the mutamycete. Mutamycete? The fabrication method of each bioweapon was to introduce the mutamycete genome to a pre-stage 4 human embryo and perform cultivation in a controlled environment over a period of 38 to 40 weeks. The result organisms were referred to as candidate specimens and graded based upon usability, from the impractical and faulty Series A through D to the perfected E series. A common appearance was selected for the bioweapons, that of a roughly 10-year-old girl, to ensure ease of blending in with the urban refugee populations. I'm sure Seek will fill in any questions if I have. If not, yeah, no problem. I'll fill you in. The first E-series specimen named Evelyn has proven capable of secretly secreting the mutamycete blah 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 from her tissue at will. It is also of note that Evelyn's mutamycete imposes a profound control over body and mind when introduced into a host organism. We will have a lot to learn about the mechanism by which Evelyn achieves and maintains this control, but the working theory is that the vector is similar to the auto-inducer pheromones used to quorum sensing in pseudomonas. I know it's pseudo, but pseudomonas bacteria. Evelyn's control is a lot of big science words here, and I'm way too fucking tired to read them all. Evelyn's control is exerted in a series of discrete stages, the first of which is hallucination. Almost immediately after infection, the subject begins to see images of Evelyn, though she is not in fact there, and even hear her voice, which is inaudible to anyone else. The subject begins to see Evelyn, though she is not in fact there. Auditions with infected subjects throughout the stages of infection reveal that at first, the Phantom Evelyn appears to be a normal young girl, sometimes desiring companionship or assistance. As time progresses, she begins making more and more extreme demands, including self-mutilation and attacks on other people. The psychological shock this induces helps to break down the mind-natural barriers to Evelyn's brainwashing effect, and by the time mental control is achieved, the mutamycete infection has progressed through the body cells, so the body blah blah blah. Wow. Well, that's all I can say is that is fucked up. All right, let's clear some space. Holy shit. Let's remove this and this. Let's move the handgun up here. Actually, let's do that. Yeah. Boom. Bullets. Try to keep them all together. All right, we got 4 inventory slots. That's all we need. Flame rounds. Okay. All right, we're going to just put all the big weapon stuff in the inventory. If we need it, we will, and we die, we'll come back and we'll get it. But otherwise, I'm just going to leave it. Is this, yeah, okay. Man. Almost 10 hours of gameplay on this. That's pretty fucking awesome. It's Resident Evil Day. I want to cheer myself up. Oh, shit. Enhanced handgun ammo. Can we go through this door? Doesn't look like it. All right. I got my answer. Although that was weird. The controls were really weird there. Oh, here we go. Look at that. I was like, there's got to be something over here though, right? That's cool. That's cool that we were on about that. Mag bullets, let's put them in the inventory. Along with our other stuff. Enhanced handgun. Ammo, bam. Health is important, though. Yeah. Well, I saw the doctor yesterday. I'm not. I'm good. All right. All right. Remote bomb. Chem fluid? God damn it. This game is just loading us with shit. Why do I get the feeling? I don't know. Santa, do you get this feeling? Like, look at the amount of shit we've been given. I feel like we're about to get fucked up. Like, we got chems. We got a ton of ammo. I feel a little overpowered right now. Let's get an herb in here. Nice. Nemesis inbound. Yeah, no shit, right? Nemesis is coming, dude. Or it's a fucking alien hive. Shit. Oh, shit. I hear the song. Where the fuck is that coming from? And run. that everybody's dead. Shit, more of that mag ammo. God dang it. I'm starting to think we should have brought that gun. These remind me of the caves of Resident Evil 4. Where Leon's like running through here. This game is what I hope the Evil Within would be. Oh, nice. You wish the Evil Within was like this? Yeah, this is pretty fucked up. Evil Within's a, whoa, shit. Pretty fucked up game too. So if we're starting to hallucinate her, that means she's starting to get in our heads. So somewhere along the lines, we've been infected. Oh shit. That was luck. That was luck. Shit, we got a grasshopper. Can't detonate it, shit. Get off me. Fuck. I can't detonate it. Kick him off. Kick him off, Ethan. You have no arms. The fuck are you hurting me? Damn it. We got our ass kicked. Are you sleepwatching? I pretty much am. Oh, you mean Kitty? Yeah. All right, fuck. That's way more health than I wanted to use. Yeah, make sure you grab the herb running from the molded. Yeah, we got it. I think we hit that one. We got that one herb on the over on the corner. All right, well, I don't know why I fuck around with those things. I should just have the shotgun ready. And every time I'm like, see, they one hit these shotguns. Like, I could have saved a bunch of health back there if I just... the thing is, I panic. I'm like, oh, get the explosives or get the machine gun. And I'm, like, too busy living in the past Resident Evil games. You have one hell of a sleep cycle. Yeah, kitties. she's a light sleeper, so nice. Since apparently these things still blow up now. These things also remind me of those things from Resident Evil 4, the molded get things. They kind of remind me of those things that you had to, like, use the infrared sniper rifle thing for, to, like, see them. Shit. Totally missed. Damn it! Missed with two of those shots. Deadeye says, I sleep like a Mexican. Eat feet says the same. Oh, dang. That's not good. Night terrors. All right, we're going to stay on this. Going this way now? Okay. Nothing? No secret things? Oh shit, that's no fun. Yeah, that's not good. That is not good, that kind of sleep, night terrors and stuff. No way. Oh, what are you? First aid. Hey, that's nice. Shit, this thing's fast. Damn it. Damn it. Run, Ethan. Fuck, dude, run. Shit. Fucking hey. Even going on. Sacrifice yourself, Zeke. I know. I lost so much ammo there and health. I should have, but we're gonna keep going. Like, he wouldn't run. Like, it was like, I mean, I know we got hit with stuff, but like, when I was like freed, I'd be like, run, and he wouldn't do it. Like, just check. Ethan just checked out. Oh, good. Really? Hey, cool. Now I don't feel bad about using that health spray. We got another one to replace it. These are guys are a man-sized zit. I know, right? I forget which. I think it was Mark Andreyko. He was talking about a character named. I forget the character's name. Actually, it was a comic book villain. Jane Doe. Jane Doe's like this crazy Batman villain who like rips her like own skin off. And then looks like, you know, and like, or rips the other people's skin off to look like them and disguises them. And so without her, without a suit on, she looks like an inside out person. And I think like Batwoman or someone referred to her as like a skinned knee. She's like, you look like a human sized skinned knee. I was like, oh, that's such a gross description of something. He said, oh, I totally did say health spray, didn't I? I totally did. Oh my goodness. Whoa, what the fuck? Oh, okay, it's just a rock. I thought from that angle it looked kind of like a monster face. I was like, what? What's happening? We're all gonna die, man. Game over. Game over, man. Wow. Alright, well. Oh, shit. So we're still not that far underground either. Damn. And by the way, I want to do some quick shout-outs real quick. I want to give a shout-out to Manshon, M-A-N underscore S-H-O-N. I want to give a shout-out to The Reels JK and wait. Oh, the Reels J Kansas City. Gotcha. The Real SJ Kansas City. So shout out to you. Also shout out to Trizzy Trinkles, my friend, who I've known for a long time, used to work with me on Dancing with the Stars, and Lady Lovebug, our four newest followers tonight. So thank you all. I hope you're having a great day today, and I appreciate you following the stream. Which brings us to like 193 people, I think, which means I'm going to be dancing a lot sooner than I thought I was going to be dancing. So where is my best friend Jack Baker? Oh, Kitty. Oh, Kitty. He went to heaven. Papa went to heaven. He be bacon, Santa said. There you go. Damn. Mind map? Okay. Did I miss anything in the mine? Doesn't look like it. Nice. Cool. Kitty. Always a good time when Santa will always cheer you up. Even when I look like in like intense and I'm like focused and stuff, like I still like I'll read a Santa comment and I just go like I'm like either shaking my head with a smile or I'm inside laughing my ass off. Oh shit. Damn. Oh shit. Somebody don't have a wheelchair anymore. No fucking way. This is where the dolls were. There they are. We're back in the fucking... We're in the fucking old house. We're in the guest house. Holy shit. Are we fucking really in the... We're really fucking in the guest house? Holy shit. Oh, fuck.
It's not here. It's gone. It's gone.
Was there an inventory box in here? I kind of feel like I'm getting scared. Oh, shit, we're starting to have visions. Shit. Door's locked. Okay. Angel Rose, thank you for the host. E-001. Yeah. The old lady. That photo was over here earlier. Who the fuck moved it? Shit, we're back in this fucking house. Back in the fucking demo house, dude. Man, talk about, like, I thought Capcom said, like, I mean, I know they said the demo isn't in, like, doesn't really represent the game strongly, but apparently, motherfucker, it does, because we started the game here, and now we're, like, back in it. Are we ending the game here? I keep wanting to see Ethan's face. But these flashbacks like won't let me. Shit. Whoa. Are we still hallucinating? What the whoa, fuck?
This is your fault.
Shit.
Why am I seeing this?
Well, we have 500 rounds for this gun. You think that's enough? That sucks. I don't know. I'm like getting really nervous right now, guys. Excuse me.
Ethan, it's okay. Oh. It's okay, it's me. I know you didn't mean to hurt me.
Kill him, Mommy.
But you shouldn't have done that!
Whoa.
It fucking hurt!
Ah.
Want to be my daddy? Then he can die.
Jesus.
Now it's Mommy's turn to kill you.
But Mia's dead. And where's Marguerite or Lucas? Like, are we going upstairs? The steps are down. Fucking A. Are we just in a big hallucination? Are we not even in the house? I bet you that'll be. Because we're at the salt mines, right? Like.
Ethan, help me. Ethan, help me.
It's so fucking dark in here. Or is she? Dun dun dun. Am I missing something? I can't see shit. Like, this area is all dark. Why doesn't Ethan turn his fucking flashlight on? Oh, shit! That was a fucking legit jump scare.
Fuck are you?
Alright, I guess we'll I don't know. Fuck, do we go downstairs? Be right back, I'll cook something up real quick. Yeah, do it, man. Send me some. Oh shit.
You're gonna be one of us, and then maybe you'll play nicely.
I'm not playing.
No! Get that away from me!
Whoa.
Don't leave me to die!
Shit. Whoa! You like curry rice, Zeke? Yeah, dude, I'll eat curry rice. Don't ask questions you don't have the answer to. Also, LOL, Zeke, that scared me. Oh, that Zeke scare. Oh, gotcha. Yeah, it was legit, dude. That fucking... That hurt me in my soul somewhere. Alright, so I guess we can't go out the back. Fucking doll, dude. That's neat about the hallucinations. That was actually an idea that they were gonna do in Resident Evil 4, and they never did. Oh, shit. Whoa! Whoa, shit. We're not hallucinating anymore. Did I just shoot the little girl?
Get away. Leave me alone. No, no.
Damn, this is tough. We got her!
No, no, no!
Damn. Are we almost dead? Is that...
You.
Why does everyone hate me?
Whoa. Holy shit, dude. What the fuck is this? Dude, what the fuck? Out. Did we die? Are we dead? Whoa, fuck. It's six all over again. Yeah. It's Ouroboros. It's like, oh shit, look. Choppers.
You're just a little boy.
Ow. Whoa, shit. Damn, dude. Are we fucking dead? Oh, shit. Heal. Heal, 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 heal. Shit. We're almost dead, man. We're fucking gotta be dead. What the fuck is that?
Use it!
What did that gun say? The Albert? The Albert what? What and holy fuck. Was that the final boss? What the fuck? Achievement unlocked. The nightmare is finally over. Complete the game on normal. Oh shit, here come our Special Forces members. Rare achievement got ending 2. Okay. Guess that means there's at least 2 endings. Playing it safe. Rare achievement unlocked. Whoa, who's this fucking dude?
Took you guys so long.
Redfield.
I cannot wait to be done with this babysitting job and come home to my loving husband. I miss you.
Shit, look at this fucking place. Well, look at how high the trees were. I'm like, no one saw this, but yeah, I guess they just own acres and acres and acres of land.
Bye, baby.
Goodbye.
They say that when one door
closes, it's a nice shot.
Another opens. Well, a door closed tonight. And what a long night it was. But not just for me. Me and I weren't the
only... That was a good fucking phone, bro.
So were the Bakers. It was that thing, Evelyn, who made them that way. But now Evelyn's dead. And these guys are here to clean up the mess. I had just come to terms with losing Mia the first time. But now I've lost her again.
Bro, you got on the wrong helicopter.
And the only other door I can see is closed.
What?
This open window
can lead somewhere or nowhere. It's up to you. What do you mean, who is this? It's Chris. Why won't you believe me?